educationists across the country are calling on government to come up with what they are describing as a stern law to curb the incidence of teenage pregnancies and early marriages. It's understood that during the lockdown alone, 2,000 cases of teenage pregnancies were reported. Let's have details on that grim statistic.
The enormous impact COVID-19 has had on teenage girls in the country could result in an additional burden of child marriages and unwanted pregnancies, a new report has revealed.
Information coming through the media especially that girls were being abused, there was an increase of gender-based violence, increases in marriages, increases in abuse and so on and so forth. Many factors that are challenging the position and situation of the girls. Additionally, because government came through after a while to facilitate learning for the young people, we also wanted to know what are the girls actually doing at home? Are they learning or not?
During the launch of the research findings on the situation and impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic on school-going girls and young women in Uganda, experts observed that school closures, economic stress, service disruptions, pregnancy and parental deaths due to the pandemic and limited access to health centers left many girls vulnerable.
Time, men or boys are impregnating girls. This is not the first time girls are being impregnated. How come it has been there since I was born? Now I'm 72 years, it has remained there. And there I concluded by saying that thing has been there because we have not tried to stop it. Tell me the law which prevents a boy from impregnating a girl. Is there a law? If a boy, for example, 15 years, there's no law. If a girl of 15 years gets pregnant, where is the law? Anything where we don't put a law, people will continue just doing it. Or they don't have discipline. No, we must have a clear law that prevents people against unwanted pregnancies and also unprepared for pregnancies and impregnation. Then I also...
Fajil Mande wants government to put in place strict measures against teenage pregnancies.
Let us establish a home school clearly. Train the parents how to train their children from home, even write the curriculum for them and train them on how to train. Number two, let us establish the schools which should be in the community out there, in Kamoja, in Makere Chivuru, in Chegegwa, in Mukono, in Wat, everywhere. Masomero Chagariyo, which schools are there, or which programs are we training people in? Are we training the women there? Are we training the men there? Are we training businessmen there? What is it? And two, three, on the school system. Let us break down the school system. One of the reasons why some children have refused to go back to school, even for classes which are open, apart from school fees, they are fed up. Me, some children have told me, we have discovered that.
He also wants government to enhance advocacy for proper planning through sensitizing Ugandans on the best way to bring up children. He advises that a proper curriculum should be designed for home and community schooling as a way of inculcating morals among children. Research reports indicate that at least 2,000 young girls got pregnant during the COVID-19 imposed lockdown, while over 100 are said to have been married off by their parents in exchange for money. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.